Hello my fave, welcome to Mice Moment, the best unit for makeup and hair tutorial and also products review. Today I'm going to share with you a different kind of style that you can definitely pair on your graduations with your graduation cap. I know for senior pictures, you don't really wear this kind of graduation cap because it's going to mess up your hair. And if you want to know how did I able to do this amazing DIY cap, you can check out this video right here where I'm going to share in detail how I able to create this. But moving further along, we are going to focus on the hair. Let's get started. So the first style, you can definitely straighten your hair to rock this hairstyle and wear your graduation cap. But for me, since my hair is already straight, I don't need to straighten it, but I'm still going to show you the process and if I was straightening my hair. So I'm just going to run through the process of what you should do. Always use a thermal protection for your hair whenever you're dealing with heat, because this is going to prevent your hair from split in and also damaging. I'm using the Chi 44 Iron Guard, and I'm just going to spray all over my hair. So the same thing as if you curling or straighten, you definitely want to spray all over your hair, especially toward the root, because that's where the damage is usually lay at. And you want to really add it in your root too. Don't miss that portions. And then use a comb to comb it out so every string of hair could thoroughly be protected. Before you start straightening your hair, you definitely want to part your hair first, because you want work from the bottom and gradually work toward the top of the head. This will allow you to target every string of hair and is easier to manage. So I'm going to demonstrate what is the most effective way and proper way to actually straighten your hair to get those silky looking straight hair. So taking the straightener and place closely to your root as possible without burning yourself, take a comb and place it on top of this. So whenever you are running through, your comb is basically going to comb through each string and it's going to target each string. And that's what it make it look silky. You want to do it two times. So once again, taking the straightener, stay closely to your root as possible and placing the comb on top of it. And as it run through, it's brushing through at the same time. And the result would be amazing. So go ahead and do it throughout your hair if that's the hairstyle that you are going for. Let's move on to the next hairstyle. So I'm going to show you how to keep this hat on throughout the day, because it could be slip and it's also going to slide. Since this part is pretty heavy, since I bedazzled this thing. So what you want to do, this is the part that is behind. That's why there is a stretchy band. So what you want to do is wearing this. This part of the point should be straight in the middle. And by the way, this cap is poorly made, so that's why it's all crooked and stuff. But just ignore that part. Do you see? It is so flimsy and easy to fall off. I'm gonna show you a method how to keep this on. Taking a bobby pins, and do you see this ridge? You want to place this inside your hair. So on the side, next from your ears, what you want to do is grabbing on the hair on the side and placing it up like this. And also grabbing another one, make sure that this ridge that you see will be placing inside. So starting from the ear, you want to grab the hair right there and you want to pin it up. If you feel that your graduation cap is still flimsy, what I'm going to do is taking another bobby pins and actually make a cross. And this will feel even more secure. So this is a very original style of how you wear it, because you have basically a book on top of your head. But I have seen that girls also do this hairstyle right here. So they have bobby pins on this spot. And how to secure this part, you're going to grab another bobby pin and place it on the side.
Then grabbing another bobby pins to making a cross.
And I'm going to do the same thing to the other side, so it is going to be balanced.
So here, this is what this style looked like in the front and also toward the back. The second hairstyle, it is a bubble two-sided braid. What I'm going to do is divide my hair in half and thoroughly brush it before I'm getting started. Since we don't have eye in the back, ask your friend or family to see if it's straight. You want to use hair elastic band for this hairstyle, so I'm just going ahead and tie one side of my hair up. Depend on how thick your hair is, sometimes you have to go 2 or 3 loops. In this case, I want it to be tight, that's why I go ahead and do 3 loops. Also, I'm going to do the same thing to the other side. Then moving back to the left side, I'm going to add another elastic, but I'm going to keep a spacing in between. Before I'm moving on to the next step, I'm also going to do the same thing to my right side just to make sure both sides is even at this point. Using my left hand to hold at the bottom of the ponytail and using my right hand at the rubber band to push it up, and it will create a very cute bubble. You do need to do some adjustment because not all bubbles will create equal, so just go ahead and fix it as your liking. Do the same thing to the other side, hold it at toward the ends, and also going to use the other hand to push it against the rubber band upward. The best method for this hairstyle is to tie your hair first on both sides, then pushing up to create a perfect bubble. Basically, this is like a routine, so it's repeated itself. So I'm going to fasten this part, but I still want you to see the process. The longer your hair, the longer this process will be. This hairstyle is really easy and simple. You can definitely finish your hair in 5 minutes. So here is the completed look, and it looks super nice in pictures. When you are taking out this hairstyle, make sure you are going to cut off the rubber bands. You don't want to pull it off because it's going to yank out your real hair. The third hairstyle, it is the invert ponytail bubble braid. So you want to divide your hair in half once again. Starting from the highest point of my eyebrows, I'm going to grab these sections horizontals and I'm going to tie that with elastic. I'm also going to apply the same method to the other side, starting from the highest point of my eyebrows and grabbing that sections, then tie them with elastic. Once both sides is even, I'm going to go back to the left side and I'm going to divide in half, then tuck that ponytail invert. And I love the result of this hairstyle because it looks very cool. And also do the same thing to the other side. You want to give it enough space whenever you divide your hair in half, then tuck it in gradually, then pull your hair through. Then grabbing another section starting from the side of the ears, and I'm going to tie it up making the second layer. With the second layer, now I'm going to divide that part in half, then tuck that ponytail inward. Then apply the same method to the other side, divide your hair in half, then tuck it away. And eventually you will be able to see a very cool pattern. And I'm going to work at the last and final layer. So I'm just going to do the same method as tie my hair, then divide my hair in half to give it enough space and tuck it invertly, then pull through. This is where the step 2 hairstyle will step in, creating a bubble braid. Both sides should be even whenever you tie your hair, then pushing it up to creating a little bubbles. I'm just go ahead and fasten this forward because you have seen this in the second hairstyle. But this hairstyle is a little bit different because we're working from the top and toward the ends. And this hairstyle, you can still wear your graduation cap and will not mess it up. Entering to the 4th hairstyle, I'm going to do the 3 basic string braid. I'm going to pull all the hair to one side and going to section it off to 3 equal parts. What I'm going to do is the outer right, I'm going to place it under and between those 2 strings. Now on the outer left sections, what I'm going to do is place it under and between those 2 strings. Back to the outer right, I'm going to place it under and between those 2 strings. On the outer left, place it under and between those 2 strings. Repeat this step until you reach toward the bottom. The most difficult part about braiding is the beginning process. So once you get the first part down, the following step will be super easy. You basically just want to repeat this pattern until you reach toward the bottoms. It's really depend on you. You can do a 2-sided 3-string braid, but in this case, I just want everything to pull on one side. Tie your hair with elastic to secure, and it's going to stay in place the whole day. To create a volumized braid, it's really easy method. It's basically tuck and pull. As you can see, I'm pulling on both sides to make it even so it could be balanced. And I like to spread out from the top and gradually work my way toward the ends. If you want your braid to be even more volumes, what you want to do is using one hand to hold at the end and using another hand to actually work from the bottom and up. and pull on the other sides from top to bottoms. And this method will help the braid to be equal on both sides. I think the tuck and pull would be the longest process in this kind of braid. The three string braid is really easy and simple to do. So here is the final look with this hairstyle and with the graduation cap on. It looks super cute and stylish. Entering to the fifth hairstyle, this is a very popular one, which is curl your hairs. So I already divide my hair in half. Now I'm going to tie one side up, so I'm going to focus on the other side. I like to work on little pieces. So what I'm going to do is in that sections, I'm going to divide my hair in half and put it into a bun. Notice that I'm working on my left side, so I'm going to hold the tool on my right and I'm going to place it behind my ears. What I'm going to do is wrapping around facing outward from my face because I want the curl to facing outward and creating a Hollywood vibe. I have the degree at 350, so I'm going to wait 10 to 15 seconds before I'm releasing this curl. I would say grab a 1 inch of hair every single time that you are working. The more hair that you grab, the faster it is, but your curl's going to be looser. So if you want a tight curls, then you want to section out your hair off to be a little bit smaller. After I finish with the first layer, I'm going to enter to the second layer and going to apply the same thing as section the hairs and the leftover will put up as in a bun. Push the hair that I already curled to the back. And for the second layer, I like to start at the back of my head to curl my hair because this will allow me to target every string of hair and there will be no straight hair behind. I just want to let you know, since I work on the left side, it's applied the same method to the left side only. Once we are working on the right side, then we have to switch hand, which means that we also have to switch tool on the other hands. On the top section, to create more volumized, I'm going to place the curling wand like this angle, but be extremely careful. Don't put it too close to your scalp because it's going to burn. So give it a little space. So here is the completed look on one side and we are going to move on to the other side. We are going to work on the right side, which means that I'm going to hold the magic curler with my left hand and place the wire behind the back and angle at 45 degrees down, then wrapping your hair around similar to a bacon wrap around the hot dog. Just to be sure, whenever you're wrapping the strings of hair around, it should be facing outward from your face. This is going to give it a very nice curls. Once again, I just want to make sure your curl should be facing outward. So placing the curl wand behind my back and I'm just going to loop it outward from my face. And the result for this, especially in graduation pictures, is going to move outward from your face, which is going to give you a very flattering look. And this is very important whenever you try to create more volumized, is that you want to run your hair through like this style. You don't want to brush it out because we are not going back to the 1970s, unless that's the hairstyle you're going for. And here is the completed look whenever you curl your hair and it's perfectly for graduation's picture. If you want to dress it up, here is the 6th hairstyle, half up, half down, twisted braid. What you want to do is grabbing a section of hair, and once again, I'm going to work on the left side. From that sections, we are going to divide into equal parts. On the outer right, I'm going to place it over and under the second strings of hair. Then taking the second sections and place it over and unders, and it become a twisted braid. It's very similar to a rope braid, which means that you have two strings and place it overlap each other, and it will create a very cool pattern. Once you reach more than halfway, go ahead and secure with elastic. To create more volume into this braid is basically tuck and pull. I'm going to use my left hand grabbing at the ends, then using my right hand to pull some sections out, and this is going to loosen up the twisted braid and also to create more volumes. I like to pull from the top and gradually work toward the bottoms and then go back to the places I need to fix. Let's work on the other side, which means I'm going to grab 8 sections and divide into equal parts. By the way, I'm working on my right side, which means on the outer left sections, I'm going to place it over and under the second sections and repeat this step until you reach toward the bottom and secure with an elastic. You don't want the braid to be too loose or too tight. Be consistent whenever you are braiding. The same method to apply to this braid is that you want to create more volumized, which means tuck and pull, using one hand to hold at the ends so it will not become loose. Before, I'm going to secure the two braid toward the back. I'm just going to loop it outward from my face to create a tighter twist. And tie those two braid toward the back and you will be done. Remember, there is two hair tie at the ends. Just go ahead and pop it off with a scissor. And this is the result whenever you do a twisted braid. It is beautiful, elegant, and it pairs so well with the graduation cap. It creates a very unique outline for the graduation cap in the back. So the last hairstyle, it is a twisted two-side braid. Apparently, I lost the footage on the left side whenever I was creating it, but I'm going to show you on the right, which is going to be very similar to the left side. Grab that sections and divide that into two equal parts. Taking that top part, you want to place it over and under the second part, which means the second section will be on top once again and over. Keep repeating this step. It's a twisted braid, very similar to the technique we did before. Before I'm going to tie with elastic, I'm actually going just to go ahead and tuck and pull, making sure that the braid is going to be really loose because I like the volumize of this style. It's ideal to pull from top to bottoms. Don't do the other way around because it could be really hard to take the sections of hair out. Once both sides is even, then secure with an elastic. And here is the completed look for the last hairstyle.
So even though this hairstyle is pretty loose, but it's going to hold itself because it has natural curl already. So even if you want to rock this hairstyle for the pictures, if you walk down the runway, now if you want to have the second style, then just go ahead and pop this off. And guess what? You would definitely have your natural curls still in place and you can reuse it for the party that you have at night or whatever. And it's going to hold a perfect curls even though you did a hairstyle before that. So just take this hair out. And bam, you are ready to party. And I hope you have amazing graduations and a wonderful time there. Also, your future success. There's another two video waiting for you to click. Don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell for more notifications, and be part of the family. If you have any comment, concerns, or requests, definitely comment down below because I love to read them. And as always, love yourself, stay motivated, peace out.